In this video, we'll teach you how you can upload your book on IngramSpark for maximum sales and for maximum profits. Let's dive into it. So I've opened my computer, I've logged into my IngramSpark account, and I see all the books I've published until now. I'm going to show you how you can add new titles and upload and publish them through IngramSpark. If you don't have an IngramSpark account yet, check out my video I created, how to create a new IngramSpark account. I also have the link in the YouTube description below. Now let's dive into it. So I've logged into my IngramSpark account. I clicked on titles, all titles, but you can click add title here or click add title here directly. And then the first step of the wizard will show up. First, you have to select, you have the option of three different selections: the print and ebook, print book only, and ebook only. I've made other videos where I select the print and ebook. In this video, I will do print book only, which is the case for most of you. So I've clicked the print book only. Now the next step appears. You have the files ready to upload. And then, I assume you have the files ready. And then you have to confirm, select two files. In this case, two files. If you would have selected print and ebook, you have to choose four files. So the print jacket and or cover are done, and the print interior in PDF format is done. Both files are PDF format. So what would you like to do? Print, distribute, and sell book, or only print book? In this case, I want to do everything, and now I've made this choice and can click on continue to go to the first step, the title info. Here we're going to add the metadata of the book. So the title, the subtitle, author names, ISBN numbers, language about the book, your imprint, book categories, book subjects, your audience, and the book description, and some keywords, which can be way more keywords than you can select on KDP. To make this video a quick one, I don't fill in all these things, but two important things are show more fields here. Your book subtitle you can do here. So you do the main title here and the book subtitle here. And then if you have series, names, numbers, or different book editions, you can add it here as well. And this is to add more contributor information. Normally you only have the author name here. And then the subject is really important as well. We can choose up to three subjects. Always choose all three and try to use only subjects which are related to the book, but without too much competition. So you can play around there a little bit. And then the audience, which normally would be trades, general, adult, or if you have children's books, can be for young adults or juvenile between 0 and 12. College textbooks or elementary high textbooks normally aren't the case, because those are official textbooks which are used in education, which is probably not the case with your books. And here, don't forget to choose HTML to use the best markup for your book description to let your book description stand out against the other ones. And then show more fields. Here you can also add a short book description. So here you do the full book description between 204,000 characters. And here you can use up to 250 characters. So if you're done, then you click on continue and we go to the next page, the print info. An important thing I want to add before we go to the next step is that if you click below select audience, show more fields to improve book optimization. This part is really important. You can select regional subjects, theme subjects like find subjects and find qualifiers. Try to find as many themes, subjects, and qualifiers as possible to get your the highest chance of getting your book found by bookstores. And then don't forget your title description, keywords, and short description. And then you can click on continue to go to the next step. So now we have started with step two, the print info. First, you select the trim size of your book. The book, how it's formatted, depends your trim size, of course, the cover and the interior. And then after you select the trim size, the interior color and paper. So you can choose between black and white and color. Of course, the color printing costs will always be way higher. So avoid that, because for self-publishers, it's hardly worth it. Well, this is a word search book, so I choose the cheapest paper, and I choose the binding paperback. And then I have only one option to choose from, the perfect bound, to go to continue to the next step, which is the cover finish. I can choose between gloss and matte. I'll choose gloss in this case. And then I get a summary, and I have to indicate if I want to have duplex enabled. If you want to know what it is, you click here on the question mark, you read it. For my, I will just choose no. Then here you have to fill in the page count, the number of pages inside your book, and your primary market. Page count determines the printing cost, so also the compensation. So once you're ready to fill in the retail prices here and the wholesale discount, then the compensation will be calculated automatically. For now, I will do wholesale discount, the maximum wholesale discount, to have the maximum number of potential bookstores buying my book. And for return, I click yes, destroy. If you don't do return, if you select no, you probably have less sales. And if you choose for yes, deliver, then if someone returns your book, IngramSpark will send the book to your business address, to your home address, but you have to pay the additional shipping costs. So you don't even, so first you don't get any money for the book because they returned it. And secondly, you have to pay even the shipping costs. So you want to select yes, destroy to avoid any shipping costs. If someone buys your book and returns it, you don't lose any money. It's like you didn't have any sales. So I will choose yes, destroy here. And I will look up my number of pages. Then when I'm done, I click these two options. I am able to look inside. That's already always really important. I will leave these two open. And the publication date, after submitting it, IngramSpark will check the interior files, the cover file, check if everything's all right, everything's print ready. And then you receive an email from IngramSpark where you have to do the final approval. So even after finishing these steps, it still will take at least 24 to 72 hours for your book to be able to be available for people to buy. So I will normally choose about 3 days in the future for the release date. And I will, I don't choose on sale date. I will just do the publication date, and that's it. And then when you're done, you click on continue to go to the next page. So now we have the third step already, and here you have to upload the interior file and cover file. Here on the left you see the print interior, and on the right you see the print cover. It's very important to have the right format, and that you, maybe if you get an error in the validation step, that you watch my how to prepare your files video and my error videos to prevent any errors. Because the files which might have been accepted by Amazon KDP won't always be accepted by IngramSpark, because, for example, with the print cover, they only accept PDFs with the CMYK color formats, the color styles. So if you want to learn more about that, check out my eye icon, check out the links below. I've included all the possible errors I encountered, and I've also created videos on how to prepare the files for your paperback as well as your eBay files for IngramSpark. So check out my videos. I assume you already watched them, and then you just click here on upload, select the interior file, and upload to select the print cover in PDF format, both in PDF format. And then you click on continue to go to the validation step. So after you have uploaded your files, you have clicked on continue, you will get at the validation step, the validation phase. This step contains 2 steps, the title metadata validation and the content files validation. The metadata validation goes really quickly. In a few seconds after you land on this page, if everything is okay, you will get a green light, your title metadata has no errors. The content files validation depends a little bit on the time of the day, how much time it takes. This one is already taking more than 5 minutes, so I decided to record this video anyway. Then on the background, it's doing a technical automatic check about the quality of the files of the cover file. It's checking if the cover file has the CMY key, color standard, and the interior file if it doesn't see any strange things. That if everything is valid here, it doesn't mean that your files will get finally accepted. Then you have to click continue, and then you will have to do the final confirmation to get your files manually checked, which can take a few days. But once this one is green, I will come back to this video and we'll record the next step. So if everything goes according the plan, you will see the two green arrows or two green bars. Your content files have no error and your title metadata has no errors. That's the ideal situation, of course. If you get any troubles, check out the videos I linked above and below about prepare your files, all the errors I encountered myself and how to solve them. You'll find a ton of information there. For now, we click on continue. We're almost on the last page. Now you have to confirm your book's information. So here is your title and subtitle, your author name, some other information. And when you agree with everything, when you've checked everything, you click I authorize Ingram Spark to establish your titles in its database. And I agree that the selections I made are correct and final. Once you have clicked this checkbox, you can complete your submission by clicking here. And now you have to wait a few seconds, and then the final screen, the complete screen, will appear. And that screen will say that you have to, that they are going to revise the files you submitted. So going to check them, going to check your interior file, your cover file, and you have to wait a few days, and then you will get an email where you can do the final approval. In the meantime, they say for print books, between 3 and 5 days, you will receive a digital proof of your book. Review and approve the proof of your book. Order a print copy to review. This is optional. Enable distribution for your book so it can be sold around the world. Once you get the email, you will also see the book appear here. So you go to titles, and then if you click on pending approval, you see all the titles which you still need to approve. So even if you don't see the email, when you go to this dashboard, you will see here all the titles which you have to manually check. You have to check the interior. Like you can do in when you upload your file in KDP, you can check the interior, you can download it as PDF, and then you say, okay, it's good, or it's not good, and then you can approve it, and then it will go live directly. So I hope you like this video. Give it a thumbs up. I've made a lot of other videos about Ingram Spark. If you encounter an error, if you have questions, check out those videos. I will also group them in one playlist. And probably, if you see a link below, I also included all those videos in the free Ingram Spark course. So check out the link below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And see you in the next video. Bye-bye.